Life is a little better, I guess.
I told the boys we're still 3-6. We got a huge game tomorrow. The weekend's not over yet. It's great to get a win. It's great to see the offense play like that. But you know, once again in the first half, we give up 11. You know, but once the defense got going, we eliminated the turnovers. I thought we did a really good job in the second half. I think we only gave up 3 goals, so that was very good. It was a good step, but we'll see what happens tomorrow night.
You had to be thinking early in the first half, even in the first quarter, going down 5-1, oh no, not again.
No, you know what? It was different this week. The boys never put their heads in, they never hung their shoulders, and they just kept going forward, and they kept saying, keep going, boys, keep going. They willed it out, and that's what we need. We need guys with heart and with will, and we had that tonight, and we're a completely different team.
8 out of 9 on the power play is more than you could ask for, I guess.
Yeah, you know, they did an absolutely great job. They scored some goals when we really needed them. You know, offense, can't say enough about them tonight. You know, putting up 21 against that team, I know there's a lot of injuries for that team right now, and they're in a bit of a slump themselves, but anytime you get a chance to hang up 21 on anybody, you got to be pretty happy with the offense.
What was so different about the defense in the second half? I mean, they seemed to settle in so well. Was it Mikey Thompson in goal, or was the defense really that much better?
I think the defense was that much better. We, in the first half, I think we gave up 5 or 6 power play goals, 2 or 3 breakaways, 2 shorthanders. So, I mean, it still wasn't on Cosmo. I had a look at the team after the first half and say, you know what, I pulled Cosmo, and we haven't had a goalie finish a game in about 6 games. Like, it's not on the goalies right now. It's on our defense, and we just get caught up in the moment. We need to slow the game down, and we need to understand what our jobs are. When we establish what our jobs are and everybody understands what they're doing, we're a pretty good defense. But when we start running around and throwing balls around and just creating transition for the other team, that's when we get in trouble.
You must have been particularly happy, Darris. You took a couple bad penalties and stuff after play. You cut that down in the second half completely, I think, or darn close to it, and stayed out of the penalty box.
Well, you know what? Those penalties, I don't mind. I mean, we talked about every shot they take tonight. They need to pick themselves up off the ground. Nobody should be standing in front of our net celebrating a goal. They should be laying on the ground, and that's what we did. And you know, it adds up towards the fourth quarter where now they don't want to cut. Now they don't want to get to the middle because they know they're going to get hit. So we'll take those early penalties and we'll dig our way out of it.
Seemed like there was a big momentum shift. Late in the third quarter, you guys killed a penalty, got another shorty on it. Immediately afterwards, they took a penalty. You guys converted on the power play.
I don't know how many shorts we got tonight, but it must have been about 3 or 4. They did a great job. Every time they went out there, we put pressure on them. And we killed a couple of penalties towards the end there. It was really huge because they were pretty hot in the first half with their power play. So it was really good to see. It was a good turnaround, but we need to carry that over, and we need to do it for 60 minutes.
Can you explain the goal where Toronto got the ball off the restart that happened? They made the violation and came down and got a breakaway somehow?
They made that a focus call this week that if the team that is receiving the ball doesn't go get it, they'll just blow it in if there's an opposing player standing next to the ball. It happened later in the game where we could have did it, but we didn't get to the ball fast enough.
Yeah.
It's something that they sort of broke out of the blue to us. So we didn't like the call, but at the same time, if that's the way they're going to call it, then our guys have to understand we have to go towards the ball. You can't just have 4 guys run away from it. So that's on us. But at the same time, I wish they would have called that way from the very beginning. We would have understood it.
How much do you depend on your players for the challenges? Obviously, Cosmo was very adamant early in the first half. Did Mark come back and tell you to challenge that one on the second?
Mark said it was close. And that was a big moment in the game. Marks are always close, but he's usually pretty good about it. So I listened to Mark on that one, and it didn't work out. But at the same time, it gave us a chance to sort of regroup and just say, like, look, boys, we're fine, and keep going the way we're going.
One last thing. We expect to see Mikey start tomorrow night?
Yep. We're going to rotate him the rest of the year, and who's ever hottest going to hopefully go on in the playoffs, that's who will get the start.
Great.